Gayatri, welcome to the Positive Conversations channel. You are the first guest on this channel that I'm planning to start. So I think we will at least have 150 viewers. Hopefully all our batchmates will listen to whatever we have to talk for the next 15 minutes or so. So welcome. And before we start, why don't you start with an introduction? Tell us who Gayatri is.
A short kind of conversation. Nothing much to tell. Run-of-the-mill, brought up in Bangalore. Studied, of course, all my life in Bangalore except the early years of my youth when I was outside, and as a child, really. And then, of course, at Lucknow where we studied together. But apart from that, usual engineer, MBA, corporate life, and here I am.
IT. Gayatri, you have come out with your book, called it Bangalore. So tell us about what made you write the book. How did you get the idea? Tell us more about the book and how did you come up with the idea first of all?
So I always liked to write. So that was at the back of my mind for a very long while, especially the last 10 years when I said, okay, I'm going to at some time perhaps devote more time to writing and write a book. So that happened through circumstance and things about 2 years ago, maybe 2019, is when I said, okay, I'm going to start writing. And how did I come up with this is just quite by accident, I think. Just that some story came to me. I do read a lot of romance. So obviously, you know, that's something, so that's a genre I like. But it's not like I sat down and said, maybe I'll weigh various genres against each other and said, I'll write like this. The story came to me and I just started writing. I think only halfway through did I actually realize that this is going to turn out as a book.
So it took almost 2 years to finish this work. Is that the kind of time?
Yeah, so actually in 2019, I was not very focused in my writing. It was more of a meandering kind of thing. And it's maybe last part of 2019 and early part of 2020 when I actually started working at it. And then during the lockdown, I finished the book. So, really, I mean, the writing part, I think, took a little over, a little under a year. And then from last June, of course, all the revisions and trying to find a publisher and everything.
How was that experience in being a first-time author? How was that experience of running around? How did people encourage you, discourage you? And what role did Positive Conversations have in this entire publishing process?
It is a bit frustrating. Publishers, and of course, I understand where they're coming from. I am a nobody, and they don't want to really take a chance on me. It's fiction, firstly. A lot of people who do read tend to, now I'm told, graduate and gravitate towards non-fiction. So this is fiction, and it's a romance. So it's just anyway a chancy field, and on top of that, I'm a debut author. And on top of that, it's not like I'm anybody famous or anything. So, you know, these are the nice things that all the publishers told me. Nothing against them, though, because I think most of them came back with very kind words and said, you know, you do just stick with it. And while we are not able to do it, we think that you've written a decent thing. So, you know, I think none of them were really cruel, which was very positive for me.
So talking about they said nice words. And now that your book is already out and whatever I have seen of the reviews, I think people are very happy reading it. So tell us more about the book. Tell us more about what you feel when people say good things about it.
It's an absolute high, I think. At some time, you know, when the book was released, I was absolutely nervous thinking, are people going to like it? And all my friends have been harassed the last few weeks because I've been pinging them and saying, read my book, tell me what you think. So I've done my share of harassing my friends. But yes, most people have come back and said they've liked it, which has been very nice to hear. I mean, initially, of course, and now there's a different feeling, and I'll talk about that. But initially, when people were saying that, I was ecstatic and thrilled and everything. Now, of course, there is a lot of small niggling fear, you know, coming in of maybe did I actually write all of that, or you know, what was it, a fluke? And you know, people are thinking they're seeing that, but that was just unintentional. And you know, this is the usual imposter syndrome. Am I an imposter? Can I do this again? Am I going to be a one book wonder and things like that? Yeah.
No, very nice. It's not easy writing and staying at it for over a year and getting through it. So how did this process of writing actually happen to you? I mean, did you type? Did you write it on paper and then you type, or did you follow a...
No, I typed from the very beginning. My writing is terrible. And anyway, I think for the kind of editing that we do, I really wonder why people still write with their hands. Of course, there might be some people need that time to, you know, let the words flow and things like that. But no, I actually typed. And it's much easier, the editing and the word processing that way. So I typed from start to finish. I did make little notes to myself in a notebook whenever some thoughts came to me, but the actual writing was all on the laptop.
Yeah. And the role of Bangalore, you even named the book Bangalore. The role of Bangalore in your life, I've known you for quite some time now, and I know that you are a diehard Bangalorean. So tell us about the role of Bangalore in your life. Why do you like Bangalore so much?
I think, and this is me saying this about Bangalore, but I'm sure if you ask someone from Chennai or Bombay, they'll say the same things about their city. It's more that you've grown up there. I've gone to school here. A lot of my memories, I got married here. A lot of my memories, of course, you know, are connected with the city. And apart from that, as a standalone thing as well, I think it's a beautiful city in terms of how cosmo it is, how welcoming it is. I think everybody who comes here finds it difficult to leave it and go and live elsewhere. So it's a very livable city, despite all the complaints and whining that we do about it in terms of traffic, potholes and all. It's a wonderful city. So I think that kind of shines through in anything I wrote in the book.
You speak about the traffic, you speak about the whining because of the traffic and potholes and whatnot. But if we read your book, it's a very positive view of Bangalore. It's more like the Bangalore where probably you grew up, right? So you know, tell us more about some of the places that you have written about in Bangalore and what can the readers look forward to in the book.
For those who are familiar with Bangalore, I think they will see a lot of the things that I've said with perhaps fresher eyes, because some of us have gotten used to the newer Bangalore, which is all bustling traffic and you know, people with their ID cards walking around, importantly. So you know, perhaps remind people of the Bangalore that it was, where you could walk across any road without looking right and left because there was hardly any traffic. But also that you know, some of the places, like I've mentioned, like Airlines Hotel, or even the newer places like Toit and things like that. It speaks more about the vibe of the city, which is laid back. People are friendly, they're chill, they're literally chill. I mean, to quote our kids, the youngsters nowadays, I think it's a very all-encompassing adjective. I think the city and its people are very chill.
Okay, so Gayatri, who would you want your ideal reader to be? Who all do you want to read your book?
Actually, when I started off, I did not know. I just started, and you know, it loosely falls into chick lit, what I've written. But I've been pleasantly surprised to see that a lot of men have liked it too. So I'm thinking that anyone, that was the feedback I got from some of my early readers of the book, and I did not expect them to like it, and they did, which was very encouraging. So I think, I'm not going to go with a gender kind of distinction. I think anyone around 30 and above who's kind of, you know, who can read English books, of course. I mean, who read the language for entertainment? I think 30 and above. I don't think there's an upper age limit. Just day before, I had an 83-year-old man tell me that reading my book brought back memories of his own, you know, the time he was courting his wife back in the 50s, 60s. I've forgotten what he said. So very heartwarming to hear. So I think anybody above 30, children can read it as well. It's very clean that way. So, you know, there is nothing really too explicit or anything about it. But the problem I feel that children will face is it's not of this generation. It's not, you know, short sentences and things like that. In fact, my own daughter told me, "Who talks like this, Amma?" So maybe not children, but anyone above 30, 35, I'm fairly confident will like it. I'm hoping.
Yeah, let's all hope for the best. Gayatri, and wish you all the best once again. Just one more, or maybe a couple more questions. One of the points was about the choice of characters. Right? I mean, you have a lot of characters in there. Each character has a strong role in the book. But the two main characters, one of them is this lady, Radha, and then you have James. So the choice of a character who comes from outside India in an IT sort of a setup, how did that come to your head?
So obviously, I've worked in the IT world for very long. And so a lot of that influence is there. The characters also, a lot of people around me. But how did this, this character of, say, a James come in? Is that it actually happened. I did have a client visit, and he was very handsome as well. Only none of the other things happened. But certainly, this was where I got the storyline from.
Oh, wow. Anything else you want to tell your readers and other people who are watching this, Gayatri? Any message from you?
No, just go out and get a copy. And I know we are nowadays a little bogged down by everything we need to do. And reading is kind of goes on the back burner, rightly so. There are so many other ways to entertain yourselves also. But I think this is a short read, and I would request people to invest that time, and hopefully they feel like they've got their money's worth when they read the book.
Great, Gayatri. All the very best. Let's hope that you become a famous author after this adventure or after this attempt of yours. Any ideas of writing a second book?
I do. I'm hoping that I stick with that, and I'm hoping to take one of the characters from this book and, you know, kind of do a spin-off. Let's see. I've got a rough sketch, but, you know, too soon to tell. But yes, I certainly hope to write more.
And would you like one of the books, or maybe part one, part two, to get converted into a movie?
No, so it won't be like a part one, part two. It'll just be some sort of link, which I'm thinking right now it could be totally different as well.
Yeah. Thanks so much, Gayatri. Just one last question, because the channel is called Positive Conversations. So one of the inspirations for me was when I look around, I definitely feel that people don't celebrate enough. And the role of positive conversations in reinforcing beliefs that you can indeed do something is extremely important. I, for example, believe that positive conversations with yourself, I mean, positive thoughts would have played a big role in making sure that you had an idea that you would write a book, but you actually took that idea and executed it, and you took that idea to a closure. So any thoughts on positive conversations as a concept?
I think that's a fantastic concept, and I wish you all luck, and if you can, you know, make a difference in people's lives.
Can you come closer to the...
Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Yeah, so I'm saying it's a fantastic concept, and I wish you all luck. I think it's the need of the hour. We are surrounded by a lot of things which are negative, especially at this time, but even otherwise. I mean, let's not blame COVID for everything. I think generally we have a sense of moving towards a sense of doom and gloom. And I think it's very important to stay focused, stay positive, because really some of the things are not in our control. And of course, a lot of us are blessed enough and feel, and it's easier for us to feel that way. And some of us are not so blessed, and it's really difficult to think positively. But I think even then, it's very important that someone tries to stay positive and, you know, think that, okay, this is it. This is what I can control. I'm alive, I'm breathing, and let me make the best of what I can.
Thanks. I think that was a great reinforcement of the positive conversations message that I wanted to pass on to whoever watches this.
Yeah, let's hope it's someone other than you and me alone.
The basic interview or the, you know, chat is over. So we can probably continue for a couple of minutes. So, you know, I got inspiration from Ravichandran Ashwin. I saw some of his videos, the way he was talking to the bowling coach or the fielding coach. I don't know if you have seen
I think I've seen one, but I do. You know, it was a poor audio. I didn't quite get it. But now that you've told me, I'll watch a few more.
Yeah, it's brilliant. Some of it is in Tamil also, but it's, you know, very, very nicely done. And the fact that even during the cricket matches and just before the World Cup, this test final, he was able to take time out, and then he actually went and spoke to the groundsmen and so on and so forth. It was very inspiring. And he talks to people from different fields as well. So I thought, you know, why not talk to different people and start my own channel. So that's how it all started.
I wish you luck. And I hope Ashwin follows you soon.
Oh, all right. Thank you so much. Tell me, how do you feel to give an interview, Patrick? Have you already been sought after by a few people who say, hey, can we...
No, God, nobody cares. I just did a reading with some of my friends here who run a book club. So it was fun, but that was... the first part was for 10-15 minutes. I read excerpts.
So you actually read from the book?
I actually read. So I picked a few excerpts out which I thought would make sense. So I read it out, and then they had some questions. It was fun. It was a lot of fun.
Did I get used to all this now? I am, I confessed right at the beginning, this is the first time I am doing it on my channel, but I'm sure there will be more and more people who you'll have to give time to them.
Have no problem giving time. I'm only wondering whether anyone will show the interest in talking to me. Anyone's interested, I'm ready.
Okay, let's hope that this channel becomes wider, and let's hope we're talking about what we can control. Whoever is watching this, one thing they can definitely control is go hit the Amazon buy button for your book. Or download it on their Kindle and read it, and quickly give you feedback, and then spread the good news amongst your friends. I personally love the book that I told you also. I didn't like it.
Thank you, Ranga. Yeah.
So well done. Congratulations, and all the best for the future. Thanks. See you. Bye.